genetic strategies are becoming a lot more important in a lot of threatened species conservation programs. There's various people that are really trying to understand how we can use genetics to improve those programs, not just around genetic rescue, but simply how many founders should we select from a source population to put into a recipient population to boost the diversity in that population. So there's genetic guidelines that you need to then start understanding, and you know, and you need to be able to implement them in a way that makes sense for a particular species or a particular program. My name is Dr. Andrew Weeks. I'm a senior research fellow from the University of Melbourne. I'm what is known as a conservation geneticist, which means that I look at genetic strategies for improving threatened species outcomes. We've been developing a manual, essentially, a manual for stakeholders, for conservation practitioners, that can start thinking about those genetic strategies and how they might actually help improve the different threatened species programs that they're involved in, and what things you need to consider if you are thinking about trying to, for instance, increase genetic diversity in a particular population, whether you want to start a new population, whether you want to do a translocation or a reintroduction. You know, you need those founding guidelines around how you source and select the right founders that have a lot of genetic diversity, so that you can make sure that your population has the best chance going forward. So that's what this manual for how you actually use genetics and genetic strategies is going to be really important for conservation practitioners to understand that, so they can then start incorporating it into their programs.